Ancestry does not allow you to download your ancestry DNA matches. So what's a researcher to do when you want to try to organize and manage your DNA research? Well, that's when my special guest, Greg, has a really cool tool to help you grab your DNA match list, put it over into a spreadsheet, and you'll want to check out the blog post that I'm going to talk about at the end of the video for a link to access what his cool research tool. So let me welcome Greg Clark from Ontario. Hey, Greg, how are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you, Devin?
I'm better than I deserve, if I can borrow that from Dave Ramsey. I really am better than I deserve. So walk us through how you came up with the solution to a problem that we talked about in the Family History Fanatics channel membership.
Oh, okay, sure. So during the membership discussion, we're talking about matches and ways of organizing the matches. And when you have a long list of matches, then, you know, lots of genealogists think, well, if I just grab those and put them in a spreadsheet, it'll be perfect. So someone had said, how do we do that? And it doesn't work. And so I replied in the chat, it's easy. You just copy and maybe you just control V or maybe control shift V, something, you know, simple. And they tried it and it didn't work. And I was, of course, shocked and aghast. And sure enough, it's true. Because first of all, Ancestry doesn't have a way to download it automatically like some platforms do. And then when you do just a bald copy and paste, it doesn't format very nice at all. So luckily, I've done lots of spreadsheet work and played with formulas. So I thought this is just a problem that we can solve with a few formulas. So I've done that. So I will share that with you now. So what I'm sharing now, put down the steps so that you can follow it. And this is in a Google spreadsheet, and it's got two tabs. And if you look at the bottom, there's one tab that has the instructions, and the second tab is the worksheet that actually is where your matches will show, where you dump the data and your matches will get formatted. What I would suggest is that when you first go to this, if you make a copy for yourself, and then you can save it in your own drive.
This is so, so important because we are going to make this spreadsheet for Google available through the link in the blog post that I'm going to talk about later. But you're not going to get requests to edit. Make a copy and save it to your own Google Drive, and then you'll always have a copy to use for yourself.
And the nice thing about that is when you do make a copy, so I've just made a copy now, and you can say my ancestry DNA match paper. Now, whatever I do here, Devin's not going to see on her version of the matchmaker. So because, I mean, people's DNA matches is kind of a personal information. So though I'm apparently sharing all of mine. So so that's step number one, and that's important. It is in Google, it's in a Google spreadsheet because that's the platform that can be viewed on a Mac and on a Windows, and the formulas will work the same. Now, if you save it as an Excel file, I haven't tried this on Excel, but if you were to download it as Excel, I know there are some differences in the way formulas work, and I'm using some fairly sophisticated formulas. Usually it goes the opposite way. The Excel formulas don't always work with the Google formulas. I can't guarantee it'll work on the Excel. So basically, step one is after you've made the copy, so you go to your ancestry DNA list, and all you have to do is highlight all of the text and copy it. And the easiest way to do that is on a Windows PC, you just do Control A for all. On a Mac, it's Command A. And I don't know if you can tell, but the text has been highlighted. I'm then going to go Control C or Command C on a Mac to copy it. And then going back to the spreadsheet, over on the worksheet area, starting at the cell that's highlighted in yellow, that's your target. Put your cursor there at the yellow cell. And then what you're going to do is paste. And you can either do a Control V or a Control Shift V. I'm going to do the Shift Control V because it takes out all the formatting. And this is a pro tip for when you're copying and pasting on a computer. If you've copied a bunch of text and it has different formatting, like some bold, some underlining, maybe some hyperlinks or whatever. If all you want is the actual text and you don't want all the extra HIP formatting because it makes it look ugly, then Shift Control V or Shift Command V on a Mac will paste the text without doing it all the extra stuff. So you saw that I pasted it. There was a pause there while I kept on talking long enough to give the computer time to do some computations. And now, if you look, you can see that all of a sudden, I have a whole pile of information that's all sorted. All this stuff from this column G onwards is the information that's been sorted by my various formulas that are hidden in the background.
Wow. You recommend the Control Shift and the Shift plus Control plus V all at the same time. Yep. Dump it in there and just give it moments. And then all of a sudden, the right side popped up.
That's exactly it. So I parsed it so it shows the name of the person. Now, in some cases, and if you look at the list, sometimes you'll see, like there's one, there's a KR. KR is managed by Victoria, okay? So there's two names and that's going to be in that column. One's the person and one is the DNA kit manager.
Nice.
In other ones, there's just a single name. And then sometimes there's a category and then a name.
Okay.
It seems a little inconsistent, but I've tried to work the formula so it would guess and plot things properly. All of these people are your matches. Mm-hmm. They match to you. And you can look at the centimorgans.
Yes.
Column K tells you how much. And it by default, now I use the default, which is most to least. If you sort it some other way, sometimes I found the formulas don't work as well.
Okay.
And I'm not sure why that is, but generally most to least is the one that's the most useful anyways. Mm-hmm. And you can tell some that have trees and some that don't have trees. And then the ones at the bottom here don't have any type of trees, it looks like. They found a common ancestor, how many people are in the tree if they had one. And I use notes a lot. And so what's nice is it also brings over your notes and then puts that there. The way I use notes, I put the family name, the surname, and then the relationship. So first cousin once removed, for example. Mm-hmm. And then the actual connection of who that the granddaughter of or daughter, you know, so it makes it easier for me to find. I've tried to make it fairly straightforward to use.
We wanted to do sorting and manipulation. I know there's a way to copy things without the formulas, and then you create essentially a duplicate.
Yes.
Could you... Yes. Walk us through that.
I can certainly do it. That's an excellent suggestion. Okay, so to do that, because this page is all reliant on the data in column A, and then it auto-populates the stuff all through the rest of it. But you're right. If you want to manipulate it, you want to copy this information just as it is. So what I do is I'm highlighting columns G to P. So what I did was I clicked on the letter G, okay, so that you can see that column G is now all highlighted. And then I'm going to go over and then I'm going to hold my shift key down with, I'm holding my shift key down here. And then I'm going to click on the P up here.
Okay.
And then that's going to highlight all of those columns in between.
Gotcha.
Including the G and the P. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go Control C or maybe I am going to go edit copy. Same sort of thing, Command C. And now I'm going to go down here and add a new sheet. Okay. I'm in the very bottom. Can you see where I am?
Yes.
I'm in the bottom left corner. I'm adding a new blank sheet. And I'm going to do that trick I did before, Control Shift V.
Control plus the Shift plus the V.
That's
all
right.
Three of them. And all if you're on a Mac, Command plus the Shift plus the V.
That's
all
exactly.
Three of them at the same time.
Actually, what you should do, if you're doing one of those combinations, put the Shift and the Command or Shift and Control down first, hit the V at the very end.
Oh, okay.
For all of those ones, use the letter last.
Okay.
Because if you're a little shaky and you hit the letter first, then it doesn't always work.
Okay. There you go.
Oh, you know what? It's probably thinking. There, it worked. Now, sometimes it takes a while. If you've copied the whole column, that takes a lot of memory. You might think it's actually broken and it may spin out of control, but it should pop up. What I can do is let me go back and I could show you a different way of doing the same sort of thing.
Please do.
Instead of highlighting the whole column, because if you scroll down, the column goes forever and ever and ever. Well, it doesn't go forever and ever, but it goes down to as many lines as there were in the original table here. which, you know, is in the hundreds. But really, I only need the first 52. So I'm going to click on the top left cell that I want, which is going to be the category name in G2. I'm going to then move my cursor into, I'm going to be in column P, because that's where the notes are. I want the notes. And I'm just going to go down until, I'm just scrolling down until I find where I want, which is be right 52. So I'm just trying to find where those line up. There we go. And I'm going to hold my shift key down, holding the shift key down, pointing to myself, holding the shift key, and I'm clicking on this cell here, P52.
You clicked on the cell category name.
Yep.
You moved your mouse without touching anything over to the one that has a little note, and then you hit your shift and clicked in the cell, and you were good to go.
That's exactly it.
Okay.
Now, if you have a mouse, you can actually click on the category name and drag and highlight all at once. There is another way that you can do it, actually. Click on the category name, and this one, okay, hold the shift key down right at the beginning.
Okay.
And this is kind of a cool trick. Then I'm using my arrow keys.
Oh, on your keyboard.
On my keyboard. And as I use the arrow key to go down, you've got a lot more control actually this way.
Oh, nice. Yeah. For those of us with unsteady hands.
No, but you see that? So that actually, and then once I got all the way down, then I started using my
arrow key.
That's actually probably the easiest way, if the most controlled way.
Nice. So now how do you copy it?
Control C,
okay.
Command C, or edit copy.
Gotcha.
And then see how fast that there was no delay there.
No.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go add a new sheet. Now, again, you're going to do Control Shift V, paste the values only, and then you've got just the data.
So much faster. Okay, Greg, question of the day. That seems to be page one. How do we get page two of DNA matches?
Ancestry, in one of their most recent changes, they give you a certain amount. And then if you scroll to the bottom of the page, they say, oh, I guess he wants more. So I guess the trick is to make sure that the page that you're copying has all the ones you want.
Okay.
And if they don't, then just wait a sec. Ancestry will load up more.
Okay.
Control Shift V, paste. Now the top one should still be the same, but I should now have more than row 52.
And you do.
I've got some new names.
Okay. Oh,
new names with notes. So yeah.
Awesome.
I was thinking that I was done so soon.
Okay. So that kind of leads us to the question, is that sometimes we're going to come back and there's going to be more people, new people. Like if we do this a month from now, we can put it in there and it will override the table. Some things may shift. Most things will stay the same. And then when you want to manipulate it, then you do the highlight copy of just those cells, the second method, and start a new sheet and put things in there. That way, if you did any kind of sorting or extra notes in your spreadsheet, you're not affecting that.
Right.
Nice. That's pretty slick. Thank you so much, Greg, for helping us do that. I think this is going to be a really, really handy tool to help us get shared matches into our DNA sheet. Greg did put his email. He put his email in this spreadsheet, and you can contact him directly if you have any questions or something stops working. But you can access the link for the spreadsheet over on our blog. You can look where the description of this video is, and there will be a direct link, but that's how you find it. It will be over there. It is free for you to access. If you have any other tweaks and suggestions, so make sure you send them Greg's way.